Okay, here are some of the craziest spiders I've shown on this channel. I collected them when visiting my relatives at their beach bungalow. Let's meet our new addition, shall we? First up are four-toed spiders. They are named after their two long spinnerets, which are basically silk-making organs. To learn more about how spiders make their webs, check out the video over here. Three of these specimens belong to the light side, whereas only one of them is from
the dark side.
Next up is a funnel web spider. Not that strange to be honest, but still cool regardless. Funnel web spiders over here make very awesome webs. We'll get into it a bit later. The strangest of the lot is this. Is this even a spider or is it one of these ants? If you guessed ant, then you are wrong. Meet the weaver ant mimicking spider, also known as Marmarachne pataleoides. It is a jumping spider which basically mimics the look of an Asian weaver ant. It's to deter predators. Asian weaver ants taste a bit bitter and also spray formic acid. Also, mimicking their look gives the jumping spider the opportunity to feast on their brood. Now that we know what these spiders are, let's get into rehousing them. I constructed 5 enclosures for the two-tailed spiders. They need a lot of climbing space. Next, I made one for the funnel web spider with lots of anchoring points for its web. And this setup was made for the ant mimicking spider. I started off by rehousing the funnel web spider first. It had made a web inside this container, so I destroyed it with some tweezers. Then I turned the container over and flicked it until the spider fell inside the enclosure. Now for the black two-tailed spider. I placed its holding container into the enclosure and poked it with a brush, but it just wandered outside the enclosure. After it climbed the container, I poked it with a brush and plopped it inside the enclosure. For the second two-tailed spider, all I did was poke it with a brush and it was inside. Pretty straightforward. The same thing was done for the last two-tailed spider. These guys can be very bolty, but in this case, it wasn't. Time to rehouse the last two-tailed spider. It's super big, that's why I constructed this big enclosure. After poking it, it decided to escape multiple times, but then I got the situation under control. As for the weaver ant mimicking spider, it just climbed onto my hand after escaping, but then I put the lid on top of it. And yeah, the funnel web spider built its awesome web. I hope you guys enjoyed this crazy rehouse. Be sure to give it a like, a comment, a share, and a subscribe. This is ABSE signing out. Take care and goodbye.